So here I have zone plate and here I have convex lens. If we talk about the origin of fringes, so the source is, for first one, the source is diffraction, whereas in convex lens, source is refraction. Then the nature of light that we are getting, what is the nature of light that we are getting here? Nature of image. In zone plate, we are getting virtual as well as real image. Whereas convex lens, here, remember, here we are talking about a planar wavefront hitting either convex lens or zone plate. So obviously in convex lens, the nature of image would be real. And here you will have real as well as, yes, my mistake, real and virtual. So one will be in front of the zone plate and virtual will be behind the zone plate. Number of focal points. So it will be having multiple foci and convex lens has a single focal length. What about lambda dependence? Focal length of lens also depend on lambda. You remember that we do that chromatic aberration experiment, but that yes, we can only do if we are having a very fat convex lens. But for a general convex lens, when we create an image through that, you don't see that much of lambda dependent. So you can see that say that for zone plate, it is highly lambda dependent, and for convex lens, it doesn't depend that much. When we talk about structure, here you will see that in zone plate, it's a flat plate. So it is not having any curvature. Whereas lens has a different curvature at different position of lens. So you can say that thickness of zone plate is same throughout the length. And here, thickness varies with distance from the center. Zone plate is independent of material with which it is made. What will be the difference if, let's say, you are using a glass zone plate and an acrylic zone plate? The change would be in the overall intensity. But in a lens, it has to do with the focal length of the lens. So independent of material, and here it is dependent on material. Here there is no blocking in lens, so all are reaching to the point with same path length, whereas in zone plate we are blocking the alternate zones which are having the phase difference of pi and the path difference of lambda by 2. So when they are reaching with some path difference. Whereas in convex lens, there is no path difference between the rays which are making the image. So all reach with a path difference. Whereas in lens, all reach with no path difference. Same path difference. Whereas path difference is lambda between two consecutive transparent zones, we will say. In zone plate, the chromatic aberration is severe. Whereas in convex lens, there is not a lot of chromatic aberration. If you are using a thin lens, chromatic aberration is really minimum. So you can say that zone plate suffers severe chromatic aberration. Suffers from chromatic aberration as compared. It is there, but only for thick lenses. Here, your convex lens can only be used for visible range. But in fact, zone plate, because it is working on phenomena of diffraction, it can be used for the light which is also beyond visible range. Okay. So it can also be used for focusing like X-rays. which you cannot make use in the case of convex lens.
And the last one would be the comparison between focal length for different wavelengths. In case of zone plate, focal length is inversely proportional to wavelength. Whereas in case of convex lens, longer the wavelength, greater is the focal length. So red will be having longer focal length as compared to blue color. So that's it about comparison between zone plate and convex lens. If you feel we have missed something, write in the comment box. Thank you.